Eurogold is driven by being the best civil engineering contractor in the Northwest, ensuring its clients are given the highest level of service that they deserve. Eurogold work in a wide range of industry sectors, including house building, highways, commercial and industrial build.
Lolavita is an award-winning, independently run Italian restaurant. Located on Rose Lane in the heart of Liverpool, real Italian-style dishes, using the best ingredients, skillfully prepared by our chefs. Come and try our serious Italian experience.
The Warrington Irish Club. Friendly and welcoming club keeping the Irish culture alive. We have Irish and country music every Saturday night, tribute nights, race nights, charity nights and karaoke. All live sports are shown on big screens. We have snooker, dominoes and crown green bowling teams along with arts and craft. Pop in for a friendly welcome and book your event at the Warrington Irish Club. Give Frank a call on 01925 243 363.
Mulligan's Funeral and Monumental Services are a family-owned funeral service, first established by the late Brian Mulligan in 1996. We provide funeral homes in Gorton, Manchester and Redditch, Stockport, and we pride ourselves on giving a friendly and professional service to all the families who use our service. Contact us on 0161 432 0809.
Press this, and you can see this, hear this, taste this, and experience this. Press the green button at Ireland.com.
Hello and welcome to the show. Now we know last Christmas was a really difficult time for parents and families due to the high cost of living. The Birmingham Irish Association, along with 12 of the local schools and the GA clubs, arranged a toy appeal to help parents and families to get some toys for the children at Christmas time. And this was a huge success. The Birmingham Irish Association also had their Tuesday group in operation and they had plenty of entertainment laid on. Sinead, tell me a little bit about what's happening here today.
So today we've got a group of GA clubs, club members. We've got kids from the schools, Tolkien primary schools, a lot of them. We've got people from the Tuesday Club in today. So everybody's in the hall, bringing in toys, presents, everything to start delivering out into the community as of today.
Memory.
But the kids have planned to do different performances, and they're going to play a bit of bingo and stuff with the older ones, which is great because it's nice to get sort of different age groups mixing, but especially at the time around the toy appeal, it's really nice for the older generation to see what the younger people are doing and vice versa. So we're all here to help each other. There's a massive bulk of toys that have been brought in today. So today from now on is going to be our busiest until we break up. But yeah, it's been good fun. It's been nice to do it with Channoner Roof as well.
Of course, here at Birmingham Irish, you make a huge contribution all year round, but at Christmas time, you really push the boat out.
Oh yeah, it's been so special this year. We've really enjoyed working on the toy appeal and the generosity from the general public, everybody, when the cost of living's been so difficult for everybody, all families, but people have been so generous.
Sharon, I know that you and Ruth here work very closely with Birmingham Irish, in helping people with dementia.
Yeah, we work out in the community. We run different centres for people with dementia. We do all sorts of things with them, different activities, quizzes. They come to us, they have a hot meal. It's just a nice social event.
This year has been an extraordinary year for people struggling. It's not gas bills and fuel bills, it's something else.
Yeah, so it's just been so lovely to be able to help families that are in need and, you know, children to have a special Christmas, you know, as they should.
We spoke to Eddie from Bishop Challoner School earlier on. He was telling us how the children go out and go to people and try and, you know, play games with them and try and lift their spirits.
They do. They come to one of our centres in Cotteridge on a Tuesday. It's been marvellous to see them interacting with the people with dementia. It's been wonderful.
Do you see more and more people actually being affected by dementia? Because you're right on the front line.
There's a lot more being diagnosed with dementia. It's frightening, really, how many people are.
If there's somebody sitting at home today and they would like their loved one to come along to one of your groups, how could they do that?
They just give Birmingham Irish a call and they'll transfer you through to us. We fill out a form and then once the space becomes available, they can come to one of our centres.
Eddie, tell me a little bit about this year's toy appeal.
I think this year, more than ever, the toy appeal has just grown on the success of previous years. So, we had COVID and now we've got the cost of living crisis that's hitting a lot of families. I think it's more relevant to families, especially those within our school community. We look to try and support as many people as we possibly can. There's something about a child giving another child a gift this Christmas that really appeals to the programme, and I think it appeals to lots of families, and hence why a lot of our students got involved within this. It's grown again from last year. So last year we had many schools get involved, but it's increased to 11 primary schools this year and 2 secondary schools. And the volume of toys downstairs in the centre that's come through today is just humbling. It's just an incredible amount of toys coming through. I suppose from our point of view, what we're trying to do is we're very aware in a school setting, we're very aware there's families who have to make really difficult decisions this Christmas. You know, do you put food on the table? Do you prioritise heating the home, or what about the children and gifts under the tree? So this is our way of doing something small that hopefully will put smiles on young people's faces when they wake up this Christmas morning. I suppose what we're lucky in one sense is it's like a Catholic family of schools. We're used to talking to each other. We're used to working and challenging and supporting each other. So the kind of network is already there. We all believe passionately about this. A lot of us used to do different things previous Christmases, like the shoebox appeal, which would send toys overseas to children who are in need around Christmas. But we felt that last year and this year, the need on our own doorstep is massive. So we wanted to do something collectively to support children in our own communities. The title has slightly changed this year. It's kind of Warmth and Toys. And there was a few conversations earlier on that we felt that maybe it should be just warmth and bringing in clothing, hats, gloves, etc. To keep people warm this Christmas. But we wanted as a school to say, well, actually, I think it'd be best and better again, like I said, about children giving children toys. So we went with the warmth and toy collection this year.
And of course, you've got the GA clubs involved as well.
Yeah, so we've had Sean McDermott's, John Mitchell's, Erin Gabra and St Brendan's, and they've all gave huge contributions towards the toy appeal, the warmth part of our toy appeal as well. So the hats, the scarves, everything like that, and they've just been bringing them in over the weekends, and we're so grateful for all the support we've received from them as well.
We started a couple of years ago in the pandemic. We started with collecting for Ukraine, and we collected a big load of clothes that we took over in a lorry to Ukraine. And that kind of built on then that we decided that we'd help our local community. So we started doing food banks on a regular basis and asking all our club members to collect and donate food. And then we've donated clothes as well. So we've had a really big, massive turnout. We've stood out in the Holly Lane in a shed for many Saturday mornings in the cold and the wet, just collecting things in, but the club have been fantastic, and all our members have just taken it on board and really come to life and collected as many things as they could, which has been brilliant. So, you know, for us, it's all about helping people within our community, and it's really important that we do that. You know, we're lucky enough to be play a brilliant sport, so it's nice to be able to give something back into our community that way. I started playing when I kind of was about 11 or 12, and then we played in the London Camogie League for 10 to 12 years, and then kind of I got married and had my own children, and now my children are playing. So our newly formed Camogie team again this year is made up of mostly my sisters and nieces and nephews and friends, and so it's a brilliant thing to see all the family and their friends playing together. It's just great, and we get loads of support playing, and it feeds back into the club. The club is going from strength to strength at the moment, so it's really good. We took on board a couple of years ago about bringing lots more women into the sport and girls into the sport, so we've really taken that on board, and we've gone from having five or six people, women and girls, playing to now lots of girls playing, lots of women. We do a Mothers and Others Club, which involves the mums to come along and play. We're doing lads and dads as well, so getting the dads out, all these parents that, you know, come and drop their kids off, let's get them involved. So we're doing lots of that. We help out in the community as much as we can. We do lots of fundraising.
So myself and my family, we went out this year, started to collect toys, hats, gloves, scarves, especially with sort of like the cold weather outside, and then we brought it into Birmingham Irish, just hoping that it will make a difference to families who have little at Christmas and might be sort of struggling with everything going on, with the cost of living rising and things like that. You underestimate how much it will actually mean to some families, and I think that doing that with my family makes us sort of brings us closer and makes us appreciate what we have that little bit more, and I hope it does make a difference. Yeah, it's absolutely brilliant, and I think even just bringing it in this morning, it just makes you realise how much a community can get together and make a difference within such a small amount of time. It's brilliant.
And I know you work and you're a nurse by profession, but you've given your day off and you're here today to help out and support everybody.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Anything that sort of can help out here, we'd really love to get involved in.
On behalf of Casey Joe's customers, we would like to give a donation to the Toy and Keep Warmth appeal.
It's great to see the community coming together to try and help others. We are going to take a break, and we'll be having some more from the Birmingham Irish Association in a few minutes.
Eurogold is driven by being the best civil engineering contractor in the Northwest, ensuring its clients are given the highest level of service that they deserve. Eurogold work in a wide range of industry sectors, including house building, highways, commercial and industrial build.
Lolavita is an award-winning, independently run Italian restaurant. Located on Rose Lane in the heart of Liverpool, real Italian-style dishes, using the best ingredients, skillfully prepared by our chefs. Come and try our serious Italian experience.
The Warrington Irish Club. Friendly and welcoming club keeping the Irish culture alive. We have Irish and country music every Saturday night, tribute nights, race nights, charity nights and karaoke. All live sports are shown on big screens. We have snooker, dominoes and crown green bowling teams along with arts and craft. Pop in for a friendly welcome and book your event at the Warrington Irish Club. Give Frank a call on 01925 243 363.
Mulligan's Funeral and Monumental Services are a family-owned funeral service, first established by the late Brian Mulligan in 1996. We provide funeral homes in Gorton, Manchester and Redditch, Stockport, and we pride ourselves on giving a friendly and professional service to all the families who use our service. Contact us on 0161 432 0809.
Press this, and you can see this, hear this, taste this, and experience this. Press the green button at Ireland.com.
Welcome back. This week we're with the Birmingham Irish Association, who along with 12 schools and the GA clubs arranged a special toy appeal. And this was a huge success for everybody involved. Maurice, here at the Birmingham Irish Association, you've had a bumper day today, both with people coming along to perform, your Tuesday club, and of course all the donations and the clothing gifts you've had. It's been fantastic.
It has, it's been a great day. We're absolutely delighted with the support that we've had from the Tolkien group of schools and all their friends and family and the wider community. You've seen all the donations in the hall. The hall's overflowing now with ties and blankets and scarves and gloves, and our Tuesday club had a fantastic day today, being entertained by the kids and the beautiful singing. Yeah, so it was a fantastic day all around. It's been tough times for everybody, but the four clubs who support us, they were out collecting last weekend in the cold and the frost, and you know, going door to door, and they had drop-off points. So you know, without their support, we wouldn't be able to do half of the things that we're doing for the community this Christmas. Got 3 days to get everything sorted, distributed, sent out. We've got a list of long of your arms of families who are waiting for toys, etc. So it'll be all hands to the pump for the next 3 days to get them all out by the weekend.
How do you see it for a lot of people in January and February and moving into March?
Yeah, you're right. It is going to be a difficult time, but we've got plans in place for the people that we support at the moment, and maybe those who we're not aware of that, you know, will need some support in the new year. So we've got some new projects coming online. We're going to be converting part of the building here to a warm bank. early in January so people can come in and have a hot meal, stay for the day just to keep warm. So we're getting ourselves prepared for the storm that's probably coming, you know, in the next few months.
Ian, I know that your school, of course, has contributed a lot to all the toys here today.
Yeah, it's been great. We've had a real push within the local community over the last few weeks, and we had some all the thanks to the parents and the community around St. Peter's for contributing as many toys as possible during this tough time. Irish dance is an absolute credit. We've got four girls and our one lad. They dance with the different schools across Birmingham, so Scanlon School and Kid School of Irish Dancing, and they do a lot of performances in school as well. So it was, they're absolutely terrific today. Really, really pleased with how they did.
Now, the contribution from St. Peter's today with the clothes and so on, has that all come from parents?
Yeah, all come from parents within the local community. We've got different charity events going on, but I think the toy appeal this year, really, really hit home with the parents, especially, you know, people struggling with the cost of living, across the local area. And I think, you know, we've been so lucky this year to have so many donations across. We feel the minibus coming across from Solihull this afternoon, so absolutely terrific. And we are obviously very, very happy to donate them, and hopefully, you know, the Birmingham Irish will be able to distribute them properly. Hopefully we'll have a few more Catholic schools in the local area on board next year, and hopefully year on year we'll be able to grow it and appeal more to local community and get as many toys out as possible.
Now, you've got the children here performing as well for the club here today, for the Tuesday Club.
It's brilliant, and it allows our students to give something back to the community as well, and they thrive within that. You know, we've got an incredible performing arts team at school. We've got young people with incredible gifts and talents that they want to showcase, and there's no better way of giving something back to the community than coming to St. Anne's today.
Not many jobs you can do that you get the rewards that I do, just seeing the faces of the people we support, seeing the joy that the kids were spreading in the hall this afternoon. So yeah, job satisfaction right up there.
This is for everybody here. So Pat, I'd like to bring this to you, give it back in a minute, to accept on behalf of all of those.
Earlier on here this year, we were here filming actually for a special event for you when you received your MBE. And I know you're going to tell me it's a team effort, and of course it is, but there's always got to be a leader. But I can see today why you got the MBE.
It is a team effort, and I'll always say exactly the same. It's a team effort. Without the team in there, then, you know, I wouldn't be able to operate and do the things that we do. You know, we're a very close-knit team. We all support each other, and you know, when you work for a charity, people ask you why you work for a charity, and the answer's simple: you can't turn the other cheek, you can't look away, and that's the ethos of the team here. You know, they all go that extra mile, and we'd be lost without them.
So Sinead, you've got a big, big day here today, yeah, with the children, the toys and everything. Now, the distribution, how is that going to take place?
So we've had referrals from different people, different families. They just come into us. They've got a son aged whatever, a daughter aged 9. We'll walk around what we've got, start to bag it up, get it distributed between staff and a lot of the GAI members as well. They've offered to help us. As well, Eddie from Bishop Challoner, he's had a massive push towards this toy appeal. So he's sort of got all the Tolkien schools together and said, right, we're going to collect all these toys and warmth items for Birmingham Irish. And he's been a huge help, because, you know, it wouldn't have been able to be what it was this year without Eddie, so we are really grateful. And obviously he's offered his help and support as well during the last week to sort of get things distributed, because, you know, every little helps, and he really has helped us this year as well, so we'd like to say a massive thank you to Eddie. Mick and his son Declan, they actually done a fundraising walk. So they done that last weekend, and they raised a huge amount of funds for our toy appeal as well, so we're really, really grateful for them doing that.
The walk was me and my lad, my oldest lad, Declan. I took him from Erringham Bra, and if you know when you're downstairs, you can see the strap line. We built this city, where we walked from Erdington to Ward End, to Borsey Green, to Smallleaf, through to Sparkhill, to the area, King's Heath, Acox Green, Hall Green, Solihull. And along the route, I was just going, that's where the Irish landed. This is where we done. This is this certain family. This is where the club were. This is what we developed. What you need to remember, Declan, is this is the Irish community who did build this city, rebuilt and everything, and we're still very, very active. For me, what we purposely said was that we knew the elderly were going to go for a very hard time this winter, and you can see it now, like -2 degrees outside, heading into -5 at night. But what we're thinking again is in January, we've got to do something different again. And we've got to pick up the rein, and it's a partnership. So the four clubs are solid with the partnership towards Maurice. What I would like to say is the person who gave us a real oomph was Eddie O'Connor. Out of this world. I was sitting at a kitchen bar in my own house. My wife's a teacher, and she says, Eddie's already started the toy appeal. Now, we had just started a conversation. So I picked up the phone. You started it? He goes, yeah, right, we're behind you. Straight in with him, and he's worked tirelessly to help us. He was there on the route, he gave us coffee to keep us going at the end, and watching him communicate, watch what the school had done, what you've seen today is absolutely unbelievable. But that man needs, as in my words, a medal. He's been absolutely fantastic, but what he's done is brought St Peter's in, he's brought the Tolkien Trust in, and there'll be a couple of schools that will be joining us again next year, hopefully.
I've been lucky. Birmingham has been brilliant to me. It's home from home. I've always said that. I'm here nearly 24 years now. And I know it's only a stone's throw away if I ever want to go home. But why it's been home to home, it's the Irish community, it's the people in the city. It's you're never too far home, away from home. And I've had the opportunity to play Gaelic games here. I've had the opportunity to be inversed in the Irish community. And so it's keep me in touch with my own roots. My own community and where I was brought up in Ireland, this is what we would do. Nobody went without, you know. There was three real main focal points. It was the church, it was the school, and it was the Gaelic football clubs, you know. It's the same thing here. You know, it's all these people coming from those three key areas to look after those people in the community. And that cycle will keep going and going and going. It's really good. I would just like to again thank those schools. So if you don't mind, I'd like to name them if that's all right. So there's the Lady of Lourdes Catholic Primary School, St Dunstan's Catholic Primary School, we've got St Albans Catholic Primary School, St Anne's just down the road here, we've got St Catherine's of Siena, St Bernard's, St Edward's, St Martin de Porres, St Jude's, St John of Manica, and the secondary school is Bishop Challoner Catholic College, and we also have St Peter's. So I just want to say to those young people and the staff in those schools, again, on behalf of the Birmingham Irish Association, a massive thank you for the efforts that are going to put some smiles on many, many children's faces this Christmas morning.
What great work has been done by Maurice Malone and the Birmingham Irish Association, not forgetting the 12 schools involved and the GA clubs. But this could not have happened without all you good people making your donations. It's an absolute credit to each and every one of you involved, and I'm sure you've made some families very happy this Christmas. Well, that's it for this week. Henry McGlade is back with us with his show next Thursday evening at 7 o'clock, and we'll be here at 7:30. Until then, we'll see you next time.
Press the green button at Ireland.com.